Yeah, like check this out. This is a painting, water painting by Lance Mountain. I got it at a show he did in Huntington Beach a long time ago. He made a Keenan one, and this is Andy Kessler. You know, I'd always see him at Tompkins hanging out before he passed away, and he was a good guy. He was sober before I got sober, so a lot of sober people that I know now in the meetings know him, and I don't know, just a habit. Yeah, see Lance signed it right there. I just moved in here, so I don't have like my wall hookup. Yeah, I mean, it's nothing crazy, but I've always liked this. I don't know why. It's just like wood, like, you know, old past shed I drew when I was like real, real, real young. Oh yeah, demons forever, bro. Always fighting the demons. It's funny, I really took after my brother and like wanted to do everything he did when I was a kid because he got me into skating. He skated and then I wanted to skate. And then around 16, we would hang out a lot and he would put me on to like all the old school reggae and new dance hall. I'm probably 16, he's probably 19 there. This is really funny too, because I feel like we almost look like a baby like Nick Touche and Joey Touche. My brother looks like old school Joey Touche. I grew up skating, I always talk about, I grew up skating Maximus, and there was this guy named Mark Anderson. When John Cardiel came to town, he told John about like a lot of good reggae, and that's how kind of how John Cardiel got into a lot of dancehall reggae. Yeah, I was like something that in my childhood I was really into. Somehow I got faded out of it for a little bit. I think I was just so in the skate world and traveling and all that stuff. So it was a weird like part of myself I like lost. I was probably sober like a year or two, got out of a relationship, and just was like gonna meet up with Nemo, and we went to a dance hall. And I don't know, next thing I know, like, I was just like vibing. I was like, yo, I forgot how fun this is. And a big girl just backed it up on me, and I was just like, oh shit, oh, like, and I remember leaving like, damn, I forgot. That's that feeling, like, that's that dance hall, like, people just free up. It moved, dance hall moved so fast, like skating did. So, you know, when I started getting back into it, I realized that, oh, like, when I was a kid, it was like kick flip back tail slide was the trick. And then it was nollie heel flip nose slide was the trick. Or there's always a new trick every other month to learn. And in dance hall, it's like there's a new track and a new dance. So it moves fast like skating, you know? And I like that. So there's a lot of things that I could associate that were like skating and with dance hall, even though they're completely different, but the feeling is similar.
It's just like a crazy
bounce. Right now, we're gonna go meet up with Blacka. Blacka the Dancer. He's a big dancehall guy in the dancehall community, and you know, maybe he can tell us more about dancehall and what it is for him.
Me, like, as a kid, drinking a carib beer as a baby with a diaper on. Yeah, just moving, you know, like, so you're a baby and you can't make the first step yet, so your parents will hold your hands and you will be able to dance and move. So it is true, the myth is true. We dance before we walk, just in a little diaper like this. So we do dances, we put it on the internet, we do it to certain songs. And I got a video one day and I was like, yo, what's this? And it's this guy standing on the skateboard. So I'm like, wait, what? And I press play. So he's on the skateboard like this. Ha, what's the move called when you spin with it?
I just did like a 360 turn.
A 360 turn, right? So he's like, ha, ha, and spinning on the skateboard. So obviously caught everybody's attention. We stayed in contact from there. So dancehall is a culture. So dancehall isn't just a style of dance. It's not a genre of music. It's all of that and above. It's a culture. It's a culture that's actually born in Kingston, Jamaica. So it's from Jamaica. And actually the motto of Jamaica is out of many one people. So yeah, I see a lot of people like Eli, you know, because that's the culture that we've brought to the world and we want the world to embrace so that they can understand, visit Jamaica, visit the dancers, listen to the music. You know, it's just full circle of support, you know, by inviting more people in.
You had to know what was happening behind that door. Mm. You knocked, you were welcomed, you went upstairs, and you were in Kingston. It was
that sounds beautiful.
It was incredible.
Yeah. What's your name?
Andrew.
Andrew Blacka.
Okay, great to meet you.
Great to meet you too.
Yeah, well, one love, man.
One love, always.
Always.
Definitely, much
great
respect.
Great to hear you, great to meet you.
Good to meet you, Andrew.
Respect.
Just join us, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning. If you have a U.S. passport, please open your passport before you approach the morning door to make sure you're
going to the dance hall was just this, in general, the whole like being able to go see a real dance hall was over the top amazing. Just to see sunlight and see everybody just so lit with energy, and the music was so loud in the middle of the street going for blocks and going for days. That one was probably the one I jumped in the most. I kind of started jumping in and doing some of the dances that I saw. Like they were just doing this like kickball dance. Me and Frog Boss, we brought our boards because we were skating before. So we brought our boards. So then I was skating around, which is kind of crazy. It's like you're skating in the middle of the dance hall around. People were just like, you could see people's faces. They're like, what, Bumba Clot? This big, big old school dancer. He got on my board and he started tic-tacking around. And I just thought that was the most, that was like the pinnacle point of the trip because, you know, this is a guy, he's like a legendary dancer and he's skating around the dance hall. For me to be able to, you know, bring skating in Jamaica and people see skating on that, on a certain level, you know, I get to share something from my culture and I get to learn something from their culture. It's like seeing that guy skate around was like the most amazing thing ever to me. I was just like, this is great. I mean, it's just amazing. You know, when you drive around, you look, you watch the culture. It's like what's attractive to me about it is that Jamaicans are very, very creative. The way they dress, the way they eat, the way they walk, you know, the way they dance. Everything that they do has style, you know. Well, Kingston is super busy, super intense. I mean, especially downtown and where we were at, because people mostly take, if they're getting around, they're taking taxis and buses. That whole organization is super intense because they just yell at you, get on the bus, get off the bus. They like grab women off the street to get them in the cars. And you have to be aggressive. Like the thing that I like is the way I skate in New York, and what I love about skating is that it always keeps me in the moment and present. Crossing traffic, moving in and out, weaving out through people. And you kind of have to be like that even more in Kingston because no one hesitates. So people don't slow down for you in the car or walking. I mean, skateboarding is fucking hard there, man. It's just rough, man. It's like third world, you know? It's like all the streets are not that smooth. I mean, there is stuff to skate though, and you can be creative anywhere. So it's fun to me at the same time. Because I just like the atmosphere and the vibe of the whole place. Like for me, I like that, so I'll make it happen. We'll find shit, but it's not easy.
Hello,
you skate down the same street every day downtown Kingston, they start to recognize you. So the bus guys would be like, skate them on, yeah, man. It's about your values. So right, me, I value good food. Like I've traveled the world now and like the food is great. The music is the best to me, and the women are really beautiful, and I value those things a lot. So to me, like, Jamaica's still on like a high list for me of like best places I've ever been. Music is something I thrive on, and rhythm is one of the most important things in life. Everything we do has a rhythm. There's so much rhythm and bounce in Jamaica with everything, that's what part of my attraction to is everything just has an attractive rhythm. Part of my dream now is like to be able to, you know, get back there and really help build awareness in skating and blow skating up out there, because I just know it would be like a positive thing that they could, you know, take them around the world like skateboarding did for me. And I think that, you know, I hope to get back there soon, you know, and really just help blow skating up. Any man I forget, I say I be mine. Any man I forget.